If you hike out of the Grand Canyon, these are the rocks you walk on. We don't want you to try to memorize everything here, but enjoy the hike and appreciate the history. It's truly amazing. We're going to start down here with the Vishnu and Brahma schist, the Zoroaster granite. Here's a picture, two pictures of them down by the river. They started out as sediments and lava flows and ash that fell out of the air from volcanic eruptions, and then they were squeezed and heated in the heart of a mountain range, metamorphosed, and then squirted pink granites, the Zoroaster granite, into them and folded to make these beautiful things. But then they got all the way back to the surface so that they could be eroded to make the unconformity, the time gap there, before deposition of the sediments of the Grand Canyon supergroup on top. This is a fascinating bit of history here. The same erosion between these old schists and granites and the gneisses and the Grand Canyon supergroup was cut by a fault, which dragged up the layers of the Grand Canyon supergroup. But the fault quit moving before the next erosion surface and the deposition of the sediments on top of that, because that surface is not cut by the fault. Now, we're going to go a little bit east in the canyon. We don't see the oldest rocks here. The Vishnu is not here. It's below the river. But we can see the Grand Canyon supergroup very well, and it is a big pile of sediments. This is that erosion surface on top of it. And how much sediment in the supergroup? Measure down, walk along a layer. Measure down, walk along a layer, measure down, keep doing that. It's 2 miles of sediment piled on top of each other, deposited in shallow water next to a sea as the land was sinking, and so more sediments could build up, drop down in Death Valley type faults, and they're just ordinary sediments. This, for example, is a little tiny piece of that. This is a stromatolite. Algae would grow on a rock. Mud washes in. The algae grow up through it. Mud washes in. Each of those little layers you see in this picture is a day's worth of algae, sort of, and growing up and growing up and growing up. Let's go back now. We've worked up through the Vishnu and Brahma and Zoroaster and the Grand Canyon supergroup. Now we're going to go up and look at these layers, the Tonto Plateau, the Tapetes, and Bright Angel and Muof. You can find a trilobite fossil in the Bright Angel. In the modern world, you know that it very often, when water flows, it makes ripples. Well, these are old ripples in the Bright Angel shale. And here's a picture I took of ripples viewed edge on in that Tapete sandstone. Here's another picture of looking down on a layer in the Tapetes. A worm crawled through this and left the track. So we'll go back to the canyon, and we're going to move up and see this wonderful story happening right there. It also tells us something about a story that happened out in the west edge of the canyon and gave us what's called the Surprise Canyon. So in this picture, we're looking at a close-up of these are all limestones. They were deposited underwater. First, the Muof was deposited, but then it was raised above the ocean, and a river cut into the rocks and gave us that erosion surface. Then the sea came up the river and deposited the limestone of the Temple Butte. But then this was eroded on top. It came up out of the water. And then it got back underwater and the red wall was deposited. Over here, these are radioactive dates. You can't just look at this and know them, but it was 504 million years ago that the Muof was deposited. Then the erosion, the Temple Butte, the erosion, the Red Wall is only 340 million years ago. And something very similar happened on top of the Red Wall. And that gave rise to the Surprise Canyon that sits in the Temple Butte position farther to the west. So we come back, and above the Red Wall is the Supai. At the bottom of the Supai, you may find some limestones with neat fossils like this trilobite tail or this beautiful snail, this gastropod. Higher in the Supai, you find sediments that were deposited on land like this fossil trackway. Above the Supai is the Hermit. These are, a lot of them are floodplain deposits. In floodplains, you often find fern fossils like these beauties that were found along the Kaibab Trail in these USGS samples. Then we're going to go above the Hermit and look at the Coconino where it lies on the Hermit. This one you can see along the trail. And down below there are the river flood deposits, something off the edge of a river that we saw. And above are the fossil sand dunes of the Coconino. And right there is where sand fell down a big mud crack. Think of the Nile River depositing muds and then dunes of the Sahara blowing in and dropping down in this huge mud crack. Up in the fossil sand dunes of the Coconino, you can find lots and lots of different layers that have little tracks of various creatures, as you see here. These are fairly common. The blue there shows millipede tracks, and there had to be time for the millipedes to walk along there. And then we come up here, and we're going to look right at the top. It's back to limestone. In the limestone, you find a lot of very interesting fossils. And then we go back, and if you were to go up on top of the Kaibab on the north rim and look north, this is the view when you get sort of the north side of the Kaibab Plateau. And if you make a diagram of that, the rocks of the Grand Canyon slant down to the right, and there are younger rocks at Zion on top of that, which slant down, and there are younger yet rocks at Bryce. And on top of those younger rocks of Bryce, we have these old trees, the archaeological sites, and all of human history. It's a truly wonderful history. The oldest rocks you can find at the canyon are dated by radioactivity at about 1.84 billion years. So the canyon gives us about 40% of the history of the Earth of 4.6 billion years. So the whole thing is certainly not here at the canyon. But I hope you see how much fun a geologist has reading this history and how rich and wonderful the history is.